Hello there, and welcome back to another episode of X4 with our with a Star Wars Interworld mod installed, and we're on our Imperial campaign as it stands at the moment. We're picking up directly from where we left off. I've just had a little minute just organizing some things and changing a couple of little bits, because one of the things we're going to do on this episode is kind of sort out some of the fleets. Have a little bit of a change around, and one of the things I've decided to do, because we've got so many helpful people in the comment section, and people that, you know, taking the time to watch the videos, comment about it and stuff like that, I've decided to name a couple of ships. So obviously the Raddus Bane will always be the Raddus Bane until the day it is ultimately destroyed, because, well, it's earned that name, so that's staying the same. But we have got New Republic's building another station somewhere. Oh, and they got a little patrol fleet out. Interesting. But what I've decided to do, the big ISDs, I've renamed some of them to people that have been posting some really helpful stuff, or just general lot of comments. This list will grow as it goes, but we've got the Andrew W, because Mr. W has been extremely helpful lately, with kind of like, well, a lot of things, suggestions, comments, and just general good kind of like input and stuff like that. And then we've got this Scourge. Scourge has been commenting a lot right from pretty much when I started uploading these, which is good to see. And also Scourge is a fantastic name. If it doesn't scream ISD2, there's not many ships in the Star Wars universe that would, if I'm honest. And it reminds me of a World Eater's name as well. Way back, well, I suppose I've still got him somewhere, but one of my 40k armies is a World Eater army, and one of the kind of like captains, champions, was called Skral, who I think I stole the name from one of the Horus Heresy books, but that's beside the point. So Scourges, Skrals, anything like that. Really dig those kind of names. And then in the ISD one, we've got the Pritchard, because Andy Pritchard also posts a lot, comments a lot, and things like that. So there are new named ships, and it makes it easier for me as well, naming ships, because I don't have to think of any. I can just name it after you lovely people. So a couple of things we're going to be doing this episode. We are currently we're basically waiting for this to get to there so it can get repaired, because it took the Raddus Bane took a little bit of a pounding, and then we're going to mop up these last couple of stations. I believe there's going to be some more stations over here as well. So things we're going to be working on today: repairing the fleet, clearing out Vortex, and then expanding this fleet, because the grand idea, the idea that I really like at the minute, is making one mega fleet to push down into Coruscant and take out the Coruscant shipyards. And then from there, that splits into kind of like two or three large fleets, and we can start basically expanding and taking out. So that's one of the jobs on the agenda today. Will be get a few more ships. This patrol fleet seems to be growing, so that might be a thing to keep an eye on. Or are they trying to make a push into our territory? Oh well, poor them, they'll die for it. One thing I want to do is deploy an advanced satellite. Bloop. And there's one more ISD that I want to make for this fleet, because I was on the Discord last night, I think it was, and there was a very I was asking about the jump issues that I've been having on, partly on this series. If you remember, the New Dawn got yeeted to the other end of the galaxy. Let me just pause it 1 second. The New Dawn got yeeted to the other end of the galaxy. And on the Rebel series, the weird glitch thing where the ships are kind of getting stuck between jump gates, and just kind of like, it kind of like as if they're bouncing through instantaneously into both sectors, and they get a bit confused and they just stay there until you basically pilot it. This is all the time when I'm on board the ships. I've not seen any issues when I'm off of the ship, because it's kind of got like, I believe it's got like some sort of soft targeting kind of thing. When you're no, if you're nowhere near it, it basically just chills out a little bit. So that's something we're going to keep an eye on. And the reason that's happening, thanks to Mr. Ronin, was the fact that we've been using a setter quite a lot on these series to get things kind of like done. And that has a habit of breaking it in both this mod, and it's also an error that's in the X4 standard game. That Y-Wing's going to get blown. It's going to attack that, isn't it? She just sat there like a numpty. Let us teleport to that. So we're going to build another ISD too. It's going to be called the Ronin. I think it's only fair for such a helpful person to take time to reply and you know, help out. And it's a very pleasant conversation. You know, and Ronin, again, cool name. We like cool names. Can I please get control of this ship? Whoa, why can't I control this ship? Has it got no engine? Oh, it's because it's stuck in the... That's why it's been sat here. Rhydonium refinery. So we're stuck inside of the place. We'll be safe. That's one of the main things. We're going to clear out Vortex. We're going to deal with this little fleet first of all. This is well and truly stuck. Good news is though, we can't be hurt. Oh, I think I'll find I do stand a chance, because I've got the super armor. Right, let's teleport back to the New Dawn. Seems so that is stuck. Oh, I am getting damaged. Apparently they can work their way through my magical shields. That's a little bit of an irritation, but... Ho hum. We can rebuild a tie brute pretty easily. These are the plans. While I'm just under attack, we'll kind of just talk about the plans for the fleets. Solar power plant. Dreadnought class cruiser. What I'm planning is, because having everything on attack's great, but as a lot of people have mentioned in the comments, we tend to lose. Trade complete. Bounty on the guild, that's good. We do lose a little bit of chips. We lost the victory last time because it zipped ahead, and we still had all fighters and stuff like that set to dock on it, which was unfortunate because that meant we basically lost our trophy fleet in one fell swoop, because obviously when the capital ship gets destroyed, everyone else gets destroyed on board. We're gonna have for every capital ship, we're going to have two victories as in defense, I think. And then a number of raiders, basically, in defense as well. We're going to leave the interception job to the fighters and the bombardment jobs to the fighters. So we're basically building up fleet escort ships and screening ships. And we might add some variety. We're also going to start building the patrol fleets as well. So the patrol fleets will be the fleets that stay behind in the systems that we are going to start conquering. Which I'm not 100% decided on the composition at the minute. Our hook fleet, in principle, not our hook, our Kaylee patrol fleet, in principle, it's quite good. We've got two custom corvettes and two Guzanti cruisers, and then 8 TIE fighters. So I'm thinking it's probably going to be something like this, and then with a Quasar on board as the capital ship, and we'll see how they go. If we're finding they're lacking a bit of firepower, then what we might end up doing is maybe having a victory as the kind of like flagship of the whole kit and caboodle. Oh, poor little. We should go and save that, shouldn't we? So yeah, I've also been through the turrets, and all the turrets should be set now so big guns attack capital ships, and everything else is on attack all enemies, because that's another thing that people suggested. And we also need to look at, someone mentioned about the 5-4-6s. Where is it? Where's the Pritchard gone? The Pritchard. They have some sort of role. So it's not under the loadout. Or there's some ship sort of ship behaviours. So at the minute it's in defence. Which it's always been in defence. Because what I'd like these to do is actually start acting more like artillery, but they seem to charge in, which is not the best because they're a bit fragile. I can't see any options to change, like, engagement ranges. What I would really, really like in this game is, so if you play, I know there's other games out there which probably got better systems and stuff like that, but these are just games that I've played in kind of like my experience. So games such as Stellaris and Battlefleet Gothic Armada, they have, so on Battlefleet Gothic Armada, you can set the ship, so obviously it's an RTS style game, you can set the engagement ranges and how they fire, so whether they're going to be firing directly ahead or broadsiding in the game. Something like that in this would be fantastic, because you can also set the range in Stellaris when you're setting up the ship. So when you go into your like your custom build ships, oh no, poor guy, you can basically set it up so you can the ships do different things. So it has an artillery configuration or a brawler configuration or a kind of like line ship or carrier commands and stuff like that. What I would like is something like this in this game. So if anyone knows of any mods or anything like that, please let me know, because that would be fantastic. And we're just going to watch, because you killed my best friend. Killed my own TIE RB. Oh, someone just got. Was that flak? You got an X-wing trying to dock. Or is it flying in formation? I mean, kudos to this this pilot. If you like, if you you're flying your little patrol dreadnought and you see this sheer amount of firepower, you'd be kind of like, nah, I'll just report back to base on this one. I think. Look at it. It's like every single Star Destroyer in known existence.
That, my friend, is not.
Oh, the original. The Red Dawn was a bit better at popping these because we had all the modifications. That's something we need to do at some point as well, is go through the ships and get as many modifications on them as possible. Like better ranges, more firepower, cooling. So what we're going to do is we'll watch this little scuffle. I kind of need to keep my eyes out for the New Republic fleet jumping in, because we're not quite ready for them at the minute. It does like look like the Red Doors, the Radis Bane is coming in nicely. This is now in missile range, which probably means it's. Oh, it managed to blow up the missile. Clever girl. Oh, we've got another couple of missiles off. I wish those missiles were Ooh. Right. You attack that. Where is your ships? Launch. Launch. The Resolute, launch, and you attack that. Pritchard, launch all fighters, and also go in for that as well. And then everything else can be on standby. Where's the hammer? Or the hawk? Hawk, you go after that. You launch your fighters as well. There we go. Oh, I'm just going to try and click on that.
Pelta class 2 frigate.
And poor old Pelta, workhorse of the New Republic. In this particular version of the game, they love them. Unfortunately, they have a tendency to just get vaporized pretty damn quick. I mean, it might be worthwhile. So soon as the Raditz Bane is repaired, we'll start moving in and we'll clear this sector out. Because it's starting to get a bit dicey. Obviously, the longer we're here, the more likely bigger things are going to start taking us out or coming in and picking a fight with us. So you can see the power is a tough ship. Just like the scaling of stuff, it's like ships like this would be great if most of the time the types of ships that are flying about are, you know, equal powered ships, not just like, well, I've got a nice Pelta, but the enemy has an ISD. Boom, boom. Right, what else we got? Anything? No. Right, so we're going to start reversing. We're not going to change too much of a direction. Did we manage to deploy that satellite? Possibly. Right, so I've wasted enough time. at the minute. The Raddix Bane is now repaired. You're fully repaired. You are... What's your percentage? 99%. You can survive with that. What about that? Yeah, that's alright. So, I'm just going to let these kind of get themselves into some sort of position. And then we'll start coordinating an attack on this New Republic power plant, because there's not actually that much left of it. It's kind of just being built. Are you stuck?
X-Wing T-65B.
Yep. You're another ship that's stuck.
We've found something out here.
And then we'll potentially start ordering some new ships. Oh, nice one. Look at that. Claim it. Claim it for the Empire. And then you, when you've got you. So there we go. We've got a New Republic Y-Wing. Oh, and we can have a New Republic X-Wing as well. Red 8. Claim. So we'll be getting the new trophy fleet after all. So yeah, leave this with me for a little minute and I'm going to get everything repaired up. And we'll start ordering some new ships if I feel I've got the money to do so. Yes, we have the money to do so. So we're going to order the new we'll order the fleet ships first. So yeah, I will see you soon. Welcome back. TIE fighters have decided that they wanted to kill that X-Wing, so we've let them. We are setting up a coordinated attack on this New Republic solar power plant. And we've sent these New Republic fighters off to Kaylee to dock, because we don't need them at the minute. They're missing ships, they're on the harbour. The harbour's at the most risk of being destroyed. Most of the time. So we're basically just going to get this station in Vortex taken out. And then we're going to do another coordinated attack on the defense base. Because I think that kind of works the best. I wish we had a bit more control over the fighters. And being able to kind of like say, well, if you are registered as being docked in a carrier, you should stay docked, but it kind of overrides it, which is a bit weird, but you know, what can you do? So I'm just going to wait for everyone to get into range. Is it firing back? I don't think this station has any
solar power plant.
We've got the defense platforms, but they're not in a state of readiness at the minute, so I think we're safe to trigger that attack. Trigger sync point. I think the fighters should be able to do enough damage to that. And there's another station up there that's been built. And there is a patrol there. We've got two victories on the way. We've got a number of TIE fighters, so we've gone with TIE Strikers and Royal Guard Interceptors for their wings. The Strikers will go on defense. We're going to launch our fighters because I think some X-Wings are going to pop around in a minute. Yeah.
Engaging.
Ooh, what are you?
Wing.
Who are you? Who are you actually defending? Oh, you defend the Raddix Bane. That's fine. You shouldn't be much of a threat. We've got interceptors going out. Well, I said, one thing I do think I need to start doing is kind of like trust the AI a little bit. And not meddle as much. I didn't want to choose this TIE Advance, I wanted to choose the B-Wing.
B-Wing.
This station's seen a lot of action, isn't it? Oh, sorry, mate. Ooh, so sad. There we go. So that station shouldn't be lasting too much longer. And we got TIE fighters going out. Look at you, little E-Wing. Thinking about it, we could actually do with maybe buying another couple of supply ships for the fleets. If we're going to split them off, and more supply fleets would be more supply ships would be good. Well, as riveting as that fighting is, we could do with having a look. Why are you all the way down there? Oh, the E-Wing got wasted. Right, cool. So, next, I suppose is coordinate another attack on that station. We're kind of sat in reserve at the minute to provide anti-fighter support. That's a horrible noise. So let's just get that in focus, so to speak. And give everyone time to get docked up. So I don't know if it was while I was still recording properly, or whether it'll be a bit that's edited out. Well, there was a New Republic builder that came across, and I believe it's building that station up there. I'm hoping once we take this one out, we will be good and gravy to go. What are we engaging? And what's the distance? It's only 55 kilometers. That's good. Well, that little A-Wing's doing well, isn't it?
A-Wing RZ-1.
Awaiting orders.
Boom, boom, boom. That's some good piloting.
Awaiting orders.
Say that. Right, so... the first fleet.
Awaiting orders.
Coordinate an attack. I think we're going to take some losses on this one.
Defense platform.
Well, that's fine. Can't expect to go to war and not take losses. We need to get that thing repaired. In fact, while we are waiting, you will... is that really the closest? Can you repair and upgrade there? No. Repair and upgrade there? No. Oh, well, that's slightly annoying. Not the ISD. Come on, guys. Let's just pause it because I don't want to miss... is anything crucial. Right, harbour. I would like you to go up to this station and upgrade and repair. Confirm. Go forth. And then once we've done this little clearing out, a little bit of the sort out, we'll we'll buy another supply ship. So So I don't like the fact that we're already being attacked. The Radis is in position. We're just waiting for these. We'll hold it as long as we can. We'll keep an eye on what's going on down here as well. They're just miners at the minute and patrol ships. While the Radis is being attacked. Was it a defense platform last time that we nearly lost the Raditz to? Dude, you guys being a bit quicker off the beat. Right, we've got quite a few ships in range, so trigger. This is the wrong music for this attack. This should be the Battle of Endor music that's playing. Dum 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 dum. This is more like isn't this the Endor briefing music? I'm sure it's off a Jedi. Good old John Williams. What is the world going to do? What is, like, adventure films and things like that going to do when John Williams decides to retire or, you know, he eventually dies? That would be a sad day for the world. So we're poking some good holes in it. Well, I think we're poking some good holes in it. It's down to 72%, 71%. Doesn't look like we're taking too much damage. Who's this coming in strong? Star Destroyer 1. Pritchard. Serving as well. Imperial Star Destroyer 2. We've got the Radis. Oh! The Resolute? Oh dear. We should be paying attention more, shouldn't we?
Striking.
This. So, one of the reasons at the minute I've been focusing a lot more on the big ships is because, unfortunately, the smaller cruisers and screening ships, although they're absolutely fantastic, when it comes to taking out big boys, they kind of do lose out a lot when taken out on stations. They tend to get hammered to death. Let's just make sure we've got... Oh, you stupid boy.
Awaiting orders.
Not everything's launched. Jolly good. Let's make sure we've got all our ships launched now.
Awaiting orders.
I think, like I said, I think the order to coordinate attack does... Oh, you're the last surviving line fighter from that group. Hammer, you've got your thing. Oh, you can launch, you've got bombers. Now, where are we? Are we in range? Are we firing? I'm actually going to stop because I don't want to be in that firing line. We should be in range. Yeah, we're in range. Of course we're in range. So that's why I'm going a bit ISD heavy. So we can take out the stations. Who's that looming in the back? Is that Scourge? Why are you just sat there? I'm sure I gave you an order. Oh, you're recalling subordinates. You'll recall them quicker. Because I was hoping that you'd be gone and back by the time we got this station repair dealt with. Oh, it's the Andrew W. What was that?
Vindicator cruiser.
Was that the other Vindicator? Have we lost all those Vindicators now? Yes, we have. God damn! Two Vindies down. How are you doing, Scorch? Ah, you're alright. Right. Well, that was unfortunate. Oh well. So what's left in your group? So between those two, one group can go on the new on one of the new victories, and so can the other one. Because they'll have 20 fighters each. Capacity is 29 fighters on a victory. So yeah, that'll be fine. Okay, so that's another station done. I'm going to go and check out this station. Let's go and have a look. Oh, the Hawk. It was the Hawk, man. Start going to objective. They should be alright on their own, that fleet. Let's go and have a look at this station. I'm pretty sure it's in the kind of like the basics of being built. Who does this? Ah, Vortex. Vortex has fallen. So I'm wondering if it's worthwhile actually kind of whilst we've got the kind of like the fleet here, because this sector is probably going to get taken again. It might be worthwhile actually building a defense station in here now. And digging in and getting the money for the patrol fleet as well. That sounds like a good idea, doesn't it? That sounds sensible. Let's see what this last station is.
On the way.
Hi guys. It's a me, a Mario. What am I launching against? I would love to stop right now. I can't because the way the fighters launch. Whee! Who is that? Is that CSA? Sinar?
Imperial Gozemti cruiser.
You're not meant to be on the bloody side of the New Republic. You're meant to be on our side. So we're moving at a rapid rate. We are going to collide with the station, I'm pretty sure. But there's not much I can do. Oh, you just hit the...
Big mistake. Very big mistake.
Well, just fight back. You don't need me to hold your hand on everything. Do your goddamn jobs. I mean, as much as I love these Y-Wings, the attrition... well done. The attrition rate of the Y-Wing squadrons is atrocious. We just lose them. Left, right and centre. You're not even doing the bombing thing.
Something hit us.
Why? Why aren't you bombing? Do the bombs! Right, I want to try and back up, please. We are in full reverse. Oh, we're kind of going back. There we go. Last of the fighters have disembarked. That's the word I was looking for. I'm just going to sit like that. Or not. Or you just do it. You do you. Where's the first fleet? Right, you guys kind of like fly and wait here for the minute. That way they're not quite central. We've got an early warning system going on. We'll do some kapowing. Oh, that's weird. The arcs aren't firing, launching. Not that we need them to. So if we were on, if we change them to attack, maybe would they then launch? Yes. No. Arcs. You on strike? You'll be fine. Deal with it. Do you really need me to come and...
Terrestrial Foundry.
Please don't kill me,
Tron Star Builder.
Right, you've been shooting at my fighters, you have. You're not a nice man. Doesn't matter that I attacked you first. You should have just stayed there. Being attacked. Yeah. I would love to stop shooting. Honestly, there would be nothing more that would have made me happy. But we're at war. And when people are at war, that's just what happens, isn't it? It's nothing personal. Nothing personal. Right, there we go. Ah, what? They're making another factory. They're really trying to up the defense in this sector, aren't they? I'm really surprised that the Imperials haven't taken advantage of this. So, how much do we actually have? We got 21 million at this end of the minute. We got 26 million now. We could kind of want to keep this momentum going, if you know what I mean. Are those two victories done yet? One is done. So victory two, you are now going to defend in Kappa, the Andrew W. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You are going to go and live on there as a... Well, you're an interceptor, aren't you? So interceptors intercept. Unless we've got, we're waiting for one more TIE interceptor, so you guys are going to go and live on there in the same role of interception. In Alpha interception, well done. And then you are going to...
I was asked to drop my cargo.
You escort the Pritchard. So eventually I want two victories to every Star Destroyer. But for the minute we'll get one for each. You go and attack with Commander. There we go. You also attack with Commander, just so we're making use of the TIE fighters. Oh no, you're a Royal Guard. You're a Royal Guard? No, you're a Line. Royal, TIE Line Fighter. Pull it together. You three will go and live on this one, and the strikers, we're going to put them in defense. So it's getting a little complicated with the old line, but that's fine. You'll probably be undocking, won't you? Have we got undock? Did I not add you to defend the SD1? I mean, the SD1's already got a 546. Is that not being a bit greedy? Yeah, well, we'll assign it to Scourge then. Kappa. There we go, cool. You've got to fly through. That's a rather large patrol of fighters. Right, guys, you kind of need to get yourselves moving. What are you doing? Oh, it's just a new Republic patrol. That's a big fighter patrol. So how many fighters is that? You can see this fleet. So it's a sizable. It's an alright one. Okay, so I'm gonna get the fleet to relative safety, and then once those two victories arrive, when they're on the way, we'll move into an intercept, and then we're going to start building a defense station here, I think. Or is it worthwhile getting a patrol fleet? I don't know. I need to have a little think. Because ideally we need to go back to Bastion to buy some blueprints for some more medium ships. We don't have the money, I don't think, at the minute. I want, Not a problem, we'll figure something out. Operation Save the Raider! So has the fleet's been, the harbour class has been, we failed the mission. Yeah, as the fleet came back, the little harbour class with its raider escorts, it got ambushed at the gate by this stupid patrol group. And it was an accident. So we're just going to deal with these guys. Still basically just waiting for everything to get built and stuff like that, and ships to get repaired and things like that. And now I'm going to be building a couple of raiders by the looks of it. X-wing XJ3. Oh, they're using an XJ3. So they seem to be up in the game a little bit. As we know, the XJ3 is the far superior fighter. Should we scout out? Right, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to not, it won't be a two-parter for you guys, but it's going to be a two-parter for me. Start going to object. Ooh, a trade chibi. We'll just check out what's going on with this station. If it's under construction, which it most likely is, we'll probably be able to take it out on its own. while the rest of the fleet does its thing. And we'll let everything kind of like, yeah, do whatever it's doing. Again, I don't know whether or not at the minute it's going to be worthwhile building the defense station in this sector, because it's not like Vortex is actually worth much, because there's helium and methane, but that's about it. It's not a like a Goldilocks system. You would have thought with how bright it is, the power, the solar energy would be like at least 200%, but alas, it's not. So we're going to take out this little station, then I'm going to drop a satellite on this jump gate, so I've got an idea of what's going on. Oh no, the arc. Will it land? Striking. Guys, don't launch. No, don't do it.
Oh. Awaiting orders.
I didn't want to come here. Thanks, guys. You made me overshoot.
Awaiting orders.
Swing around. Yeah, we'll drop a satellite at this gate, so then I can get a better idea of what's coming around. I mean, we could actually send our fleet to protect this gate, which would be slightly advantageous, because then it's going to take out these patrol groups that seem to be just ignoring the fact that their pelter is currently being
pelter class 1 transport
hammered.
Awaiting orders.
I would imagine this is probably they're attempting to build another defense base. Oh no, it's got an E-pier on, so why would usually New Republic don't have E-piers on their defense base. Is that another sign of our fleet ship? Trying to get out of dodge. Pew pew pew.
We were hit.
Just, I'm not even acknowledging it. I'm not even acknowledging it. Let's get going.
That was a bad move.
So we'll take out the pelter first. Who do you belong to? Your BNC.
Acclimator 1 transport.
Sinar again.
Pelter class 1 transport.
I don't know why Sinar are helping the New Republic. You would have thought that because the trade with the Empire and stuff like that, they'd be, mind you, saying that Q8's not strictly, like, you can, if we figured out where Q8 drive yards were, we could trade with them and not have any issue. There we go. Right, we're in range now. Pew pew.
Requesting permission to dock.
Docking permission. Taking serious damage.
Not the New Republic, is it? Clone Wars era guns do look a bit dweeby, if I'm honest. We should be able to get that, surely. Something's firing at us. What? Is that a pelter?
Awaiting orders.
How very dare you. Right, so we'll
awaiting orders.
Dice and slice those up. E-Wing's making a bit of a mess of one of our fighters. Should send it some support. Currently don't have any support. Well, we can fly forward.
Why are you shooting me?
Why am I shooting you? I don't even know who you are. I've got faith in the Ark. He should be able to deal with the E-Wing. Surprised we've still got missiles left in this. Boom, boom! So if nothing else, this will be costing the New Republic quite a bit in credits and stuff like that. So in a lot of ways, we're kind of like baiting them and harming their economy that way. I'm going to turn off the proton launcher because we don't need it at the minute. I mean, those four missiles might actually finish it. We're really desperate to get a Durasteel foundry built in this sector. Looks like have they managed to get some defense platforms done?
Durasteel foundry.
So much shooting at us anyway. Maybe that defense platform at the back's actually got some guns on. Maybe. There's a good view, isn't it? Although it's like the Venator is so much smaller compared to the later Imperial models. It's the perfect size though, I think, for a battleship, for your main big boy battleship. It's not too big, doesn't need, like, comparatively speaking, it's more manageable crew wise and stuff like that. Oh, wrong way.
Go away.
Oh, no, I got X-Wing bugging us again. Let's take a dive. Yeah, it's managed to get one cannon on the go. Waiting orders. Well, you know your job. You guys have been doing it long enough now. There we go. Boom, boom, boom. I think we're going to push. I don't think we're going to bother dropping defense base in Vortex. Hopefully the Imperials all decide to do it for us. If nothing else, hopefully the AI... So with us taking out most of Vortex... you're not so good now, are you? Little E-Wing. With Vortex basically being now neutral, I don't think the AI will push through until they retake this system, which buys us a little bit of time to rebuild or build up the mega fleet.
Awaiting orders.
And then push, basically, have a big push.
Awaiting orders.
because unless we made quite a beefy defense fleet, I don't think there'd be much we can do to hold this sector at the minute. If the new, mind you, saying that our fleet's in there, I don't honestly don't know. I'm a bit confuddled by the whole situation and scenario of what we should be focusing on. Oh, they've got another station down there. Bloody stations everywhere. Right, I'm going to aim slightly off to the side, just in case, with the ship's docking, when we come to stop it, it breaks. I don't know why the Galactic Empire is mounting a defence in Odd Mantell. Odd Mantell is pretty much secure as it stands at the minute. The only Mandalorians could potentially push in. If the New Republic pushed in, we'd know about it, because obviously we're in system. That traitorous Sinar. Oh no, it's a banking clan one.
Last order could not be completed.
I know you can't dock, because I'm at travel speed and you were too slow. Right, how far away are we? Civilian advanced satellite, that'll get us some coverage down. I thought that was there, down here, so we can see what's going on. Let's have a look at this station. If we can get the silhouette, we can get an idea of what it potentially is. Because the longer we leave this fleet in kind of situ, the more the like. Even though it's not actually doing it. Why are you all sat like that? I don't know where the wind will blow.
Autopilot, disengage.
Yeah, the more time the fleet's got to like repair it, the service crews have got a chance to do any mini repairs and stuff. I suppose. Let's do a nice reverse turn. Now, are you a proper station or are you a shell? If you're a shell, we'll take you out. If you aren't a shell, we'll bring back our friends. So we've got good, decent coverage now. We can kind of see what's going on in this system. You're trying to repair at the ship that's not the supply ship. Which I don't understand why. We don't understand. Sometimes. I mean, I don't envy the job of the mod developers on this. They make a fantastic mod for us all to enjoy, that is for sure.
Neutron Star Builder Factory.
And making these models and then get like doing whatever they do coding wise to try and make them work, it must be a pain in the neck. So you're a factory, are you? What kind of factory? Do you have any guns? Looks like it was going to be a big one if the build area's out there. And stop. And I would like you to attack, please. Wow, big bones. You
acknowledged.
Have fire. Do you have enough firepower though? That is the question. No one withstands the New Dawn. Oh, let's turn his missiles back on. Boom, 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 boom. Well, I'm glad we've come to this factory now. That would have been a bit of a troublesome one, I think. Oh, see it. We accidentally killed a banking clan drone. They didn't like it. Does that mean you've fallen out with... No, just the drones. It's a goddamn drone rebellion, kids. Get killing. There we go, look at that. It is sometimes nice just to be in this kind of like first person view.
Building drone.
Oh.
Factory.
So some of them are against us, others aren't against us. Civil war among the drone community. Station. So what sort of
engaging.
Oh, I see what they've done there. That actually looks pretty nifty. So they've used the standard 3-pier as the main core structure of the station. That's pretty cool. That I like that. It looks cool. I mean, the New Republic have definitely put in a lot of resources and money into this sector. Let's just make sure there's no big bad fleets on the way. No. I am so surprised the New Republic hasn't sent anything through. I mean, it's probably going to be worthwhile going through in TIE Phantom through there. Just to check out what's actually occurring. Because I've got a feeling there might be a defence fleet waiting on the end of Doran. Unless they're pushing on the Inote Federation. Or they're getting pushed back Mandalorians, maybe? I don't know. Obviously most of the Imperial Ascendancy is pretty much been taken out now. I would like to have a go with an Imperial Ascendancy start at some point, but I don't know like whether or not it'd actually be how will it go as it stands at the minute, because obviously the Imperial Ascendancy on our Rebel Trader playthrough and this playthrough, they pretty much got knocked out straight away. They seem to get hammered pretty badly.
Awaiting orders.
Beautiful. Right, so I am going to take a little break.
Awaiting orders.
And we'll rejoin the fleet and then figure out what we're doing. We'll buy some more ships, I think. How much money are we making? 47 million. That's a nice number. Yeah, I need to order some raiders. Because we're down to two raiders now. Our raider groups are not doing particularly well. You've got your 10, you've got 6, and your 4 will give you 10. Yeah, I think it's going well. So we've taken Vortex, next stop will be Doran. In fact, I know I keep saying I'm gonna have a little rest in a minute, but damn it, I don't want to just yet. It's like at the moment I'm at that stage of tired where I don't actually want to. I want to go to bed and lay down. But on the same time, I'm kind of like doing that toddler thing where you're like,
Imperial Star
Destroyer. Nope, I'm going to stay awake as long as I want, and I'm going to do everything I want, and there's nothing you can do about it, and I'm going to have a tantrum. And complain about not feeling well. Right. So yeah, go see these diving arc, or just dive in any old fighter, fly through, have a look at Doran. Then we'll call it an episode. No, we'll not call it an episode. We'll call it a break. Alright, you guys wanna catapult me off into the ethos? You chase that Millennium Falcon YT-1300 high tech trader. Half the fleet's facing one way, the other half's facing the other. Jolly good.
Last order could not be completed.
Oh, shut up. Right, I'm gonna teleport to you. I know it's much cooler and thematic if we wait for signal. You shouldn't have any odds. We go to the bridge and everything like that. But.
Hello.
Hello.
Piper, you'll not be able to breathe with your head out there. You'll die. But will you die?
Jump beacon, Thorin.
Is that because like, so obviously like most, Abijah Ray. That's down at the bottom, isn't it? Ooh, the Imperials are making a push down there. Maybe that's where the New Republic fleet is. Pause. So that's contested sector. That's contested sector. Who's contesting it though? So all these used to be Imperial Ascendancies. Unless have the Imperial Ascendancy made a pushback? Are they managing to build stations? I don't know how the AI works, whether they've got infinite money or if they've got a bank account or, you know. I don't really know what the dealio is with them. Because if they've got, I suppose technically speaking, as long as they've, because we could lose absolutely everything and just have a space suit, but as long as we're on, we can get to a station and kind of like sit there and dock. And have money, we could build stations, we could buy ships, we could do quite. We could rebuild an empire from nothing. Little R2 squawk at an inappropriate moment there. You're all gonna die. So So this will kind of like determine whether or not we push, or whether or not we stay. Right, Doran. So there's no major attack fleet waiting for us. I don't seem to ask to be much of anything, Doran. Yes, R2. Do your little who. Right, so how many question marks we got? Four? One, two, three, four?
Unknown station.
Alright. So Doran could be an easy push. Just have a quick check at what's actually occurring. So they've got a silicon refinery. There's nothing to write home about. They've got a
unknown station.
That looks like a defense platform. Yeah, so that's definitely a defense platform. And then they've got something up there. Is that right? Yes. What's... Is that another... Is that the last of the stations there? Attack fleet, is it, kids? Oh, poor Doran. Okay, so the plan will be then we're going to push, I think. We're going to push.
Unknown station.
And plan accordingly. So the things we've got to consider is am I done though? Catch me if you can. Attack all enemies. Ooh. Ooh. Two, you say. And that's another defense station. So that's fine. We don't need to get too close to that. We know what it is. That jump beacon. Please. Please and thank you. Alright, cool. So, Doran's going to be an easy one. So, we'll push into Doran and then we'll push into Bilbringi. I believe that's where that mission is anyway. Let's set that to active. Yeah. Bilbringi's usually got more, so backup Bilbringi. Yeah, Bilbringi's got an equipment dock in it, which will be an interesting one because we've not, the closest thing we've taken on to like a big facility, I would say, is when we took on the Black Sun Wharf and shipyard. Pirate stuff isn't usually all that good, is it? If we're brutally honest, he's relatively tough, but you know they're not built to withstand firepower. So that'll probably be the first test of the fleet. And I would imagine when we do go into Bilbringi, we might start getting the New Republic coming after us. What's that?
Vindicator,
oh, it's our Vindicator. It's the Hawk, or whatever one it was. Julio. Van Julio. Right, so everything's looking good. We need to order some raiders. Get a big old screen, raider screen. And victories. Need some more victories. So I will see you very soon once we've got some of that
docking granted.
Taken care of. I'm going to go to bed and sleep. Have a little nap. Want to adopt? Oh, y'all should have docking computer mark too. Oh, imagine if you whiffed your landing on this docking bay, you could cause a lot of damage. It would cost a lot of money. It does look cool though. Nice. Cool. Right, see you soon. Right, so welcome back. It's been a little bit of time. A day or two since we started recording this episode. The fleet's all fully repaired at the minute. I've been ordering some raiders, topping up the defense for the harbor class. I've assigned a couple of raiders to defend the ISD-1 as well, a bit of anti-fighter support. We've got 321 fighters, so we're looking pretty, and the New Republic have jumped in a fleet and they're starting to build a defense platform. So what we're going to do is we're going to move in and basically try and bait them into attacking us, hopefully. I just need to double check, make sure the fleet is actually... everyone is allowed to engage. So we'll check us first. No doubt. Are we all? Yeah, everyone's launched in our fleet. How many Y-wings have we got? 14. Who we start out? We start out with a fair few. Everyone's clear to engage on the Radis. Everyone is clear to engage on the Andrew W. And same for the Scourge. And the Pritchard. I'm prioritising the ISD-1 for the minute because it's kind of the weaker of the ships. Now, where is this fleet heading? Let's just keep a little eye on them. We should be able to see. I mean, I'm not particularly afraid of this fleet, if I'm honest. They've got a couple of Nebulon Bs, so they could cause some problems for us anti-fighter wise, but we've got that many fighters. We can kind of swarm them pretty easily. Let's just have a quick look. So, in their little fleet, they've got 27 fighters in total, three larger ships. So they've got an MC-40B, which I believe is the gunboat variety. So I reckon their mission at the minute is to protect this area. So what we're going to try and do is bait them. And see if they'll oblige us in trying to attack. So why don't we fly and wait there? We'll set a guidance point for just a little bit back. All right, we'll let the fleet get underway because it does take them a little moment to get underway. We can have a little look. Our little fleet as it gets into formation. There they go. We'll start bringing ourselves up to speed as well, just so we're on a par with them.
Empty space.
Well,
autopilot engaged.
We'll just have to be careful that we don't end up jumping ahead of the fleet. We shouldn't do. We're a fair distance out, so the idea will be these can jump in. They can deploy fighters. I'm holding off on buying any more.
Imperial Star Destroyer 2.
Radis, have you just crashed? Yes, you have. Who did you crash
Imperial
with?
Star Destroyer 1.
Oh, Radis and Pritchard. We've had a little bit of a powwow. Oh, and we're also having a little moment. Jump a little bit ahead.
Disengage.
Come on, guys. Behold the ultimate power in the galaxy. Most of the time, when they get there, when they're not crashing into each other. Some fighters. We might have to do a little bit of a sneaky fly-in. Just kind of let them know we're here.
Imperial Star Destroyer 1. Imperial Star Destroyer 2. Imperial Star Destroyer 1.
We are moving, slowly but surely. What's
Class
that?
546 cruiser.
He's changed his mind, he's coming back, he's realised his commander's not present. What are these? Patrol E-Wings. I mean, I do think we're going to need to get some patrol fleets kind of in just to keep the areas nice and secure. I was hoping that the Empire would move in for us and just, you know, secure Vortex. I don't really want Vortex. It's not really a station that I'm a system that I'm particularly bothered about. Our goal ideally would be Coruscant, although Coruscant is not a particularly good.
We've found something out here.
Have you? You found a lockbox. Well done. Ignore it. I don't need the lockbox. Why are you jumping that way?
Imperial Star Destroyer 2.
Yeah, so Coruscant is actually not a particularly... mind you, we don't have any information on these sectors, do they? So it just knows. We just know it's sunlight. I'm pretty sure... What the...
Imperial Star Destroyer 2.
Why? Why?
Imperial Star Destroyer 2.
Right, I'm going to have to go and back up at Radis. Just why? Why do this? They'll figure it out. Come on, we don't want to leave the Raditz on its own. That fleet, it could probably deal with itself, but I don't know, obviously, to what end, how much damage would probably take. We'd probably take quite a... Wee, hello, Raider. We'll probably take quite a bit. More raiders. I was going to jump back to
asteroid.
Some asteroid. Where's the Raditz gone?
Imperial Star Destroyer to empty space.
Alright. Let's hit the brakes there.
Imperial Star Destroyer.
Would you care to engage, my friends? They've not got a builder ship there yet, so that's not an immediate threat. This fleet definitely is. Whether or not they've got backup. Have they had any more ships turn up? No, still the 27. They've got a couple of GS-80 patrols. A couple of trade ships. What's this? Cargo Pelter. Because I mean, like these Pelters and stuff like that, they're no real threat, but once our fighters get stuck in, if they decide to start firing off missiles and stuff like that, they're an annoyance for sure. There we go.
Awaiting orders.
Your orders are to lure in the enemy. Because it'd be nice to sort of tell them to jump in, but given their previous so they're getting some big ships in. Ooh, now that's a fight. What else we got? MC-75. Come on, what are these fleets part of? Ooh, so you've got... Ooh, that's a pretty meaty fleet. The carrier group. Interesting. So they're definitely mounting up a bigger defense. I mean, so in a lot of ways, this fight could be crippling to us. Or if we could wipe out this New Republic fleet, that's going to cost them quite a bit of money. Sending patrol fighters out, so if we just kind of like hang around, maybe intercept some of their traders and freighters if they come our way. Let's have a look at you.
MCA designer, sir.
Oh, I've got camouflage. So that's two fleets they've got kicking around. In Vortex. The frames are mega dropping as well. Quasar, MC-80s. Ooh. Some minor maneuvering. MC-75s. I don't know which one's the better ship to target down. Obviously, these provide a small problem in the fact that if they're the...
MC-40A light cruiser.
The light cruiser. Is it light cruiser just an escort, isn't it?
MC-40A light cruiser. MC-40B torpedo cruiser.
Yeah, so the Bs. So these... Not much of a threat. That one, bit of a threat. ISD-1. So ISD-1s are the problematic, but not majorly so. Should we move up the fleet? Tell you what, we'll drop a quick save, just in case everything crashes. Override, yes. Kind of wish I had that extra ISD-2 just to kind of like tip the scales a little bit. So we look at the fleets. So we're essentially running 4 capitals. We'll not count the supply ship. 3 large ships. 9. But we're equal on larger ships, and we're down on escorts. Is their fleet better than our fleet? I suppose there's only one way to find out, really. Do you nudge you forward? Like if you fly Just fly to there. And we'll take a little bit of a teensy weensy step. Nebulon bees. I mean, they're not a massive threat. I don't like these, the torpedo boats. Don't like the MC-75. I should probably be more worried about that, but I'm not.
Awaiting orders.
Massively. Right, are they moving towards us? Or are they just in a patrol perimeter? Nice tight formation, guys. This is definitely a standoff. Got all miners. Yep, you're all the way back there for some reason. I mean, I've set the fleet up, so we've got some on defense, we've got some on attack, we've got some on interception. So I've tried to balance it a bit, so the defenders should defend against the things that are attacking the capitals, the attacking ships. So we can, what we'll probably do is we'll start targeting their bigger ships. So we'll start with probably the ISD or the MC-75 or the MC-80 Sinuser. And then everyone else can kind of like just deal with their fight support. Because on fighters, we definitely outnumber them by a substantial amount. Yeah, I've got some anti-fighter, but on Dornians. Can't remember what. So on previous playthroughs, I've used Dornians as picket ships because they're pretty tough and they've got a lot of firepower. They're not very good at toe-to-toe. Under a lot of fire, they do kind of fall by the wayside. Hey, she woke up. Getting a bit tense here. Alright. Let's move forward a little bit more. Just trying to basically... Is there any other fleets? So you're on attack and you're on attack. Ooh, free T-70 there. What I'm trying to find is just if there's any fleets basically protecting the gates, but it doesn't look like it. So I could see there how far it is. Because they have like a sphere of influence, like how far they'll protect from. Just me knocking stuff over again. Orders are simple. Await attack. I mean, so if any patrol groups go back now, we'll intercept them. Maybe that'll drag it in. You can't quite see. Is that Banking Clan? Where's that one going? Is that going to... Yeah, so they've got their builder in position. Ideally, we don't want to wait to let that get built. Right, edge forward a little bit more. Fleet, move forward. Invade them. Try and keep near this. We really need to think of a different name other than Port. Port Harbour. I don't know why I called it Port. I'm going to try and stay a little bit close to this so we can protect it a little bit. So this particular strategy has been kind of like suggested by quite a few people. It's like, instead of giving attack orders, give them flying weight orders and try and get them to come into range. Now, usually people say sending some fighters to kind of draw them out. If possible, I would like to try and draw them out with the Star Destroyers, and then as they come in, we should launch fighters. As we launch fighters, they send their fighters in. They hopefully get taken out in a nice ball of fire. I mean, they've got some B-Wings, they've got some X-Wings. They've got a lot of dock fighters. I mean, if the AI was a little bit quicker off the mark, then, you know, you could potentially sort of say, right, well, there's 20 fighters on that ISD. I'll attack that first before they even launch, but it's a little bit sketchy. Come on, guys, you know what's coming. You know what's coming.
Lancer patrol craft.
Where are you going? Oh, you're flying away. Are you, did it fly through the gate? Mining guild ties.
Awaiting orders.
We're awaiting orders. They're not biting yet. Obviously, we're probably still well outside their sphere of influence. Of like, they might not even be able to see us. Although we should be coming in range fairly soon. We will be cutting to like the actual attack cameras and stuff like that as we get a bit closer in. Has their fleet grown?
Awaiting orders.
And we've got more fighters, 59. So they're still under 100 fighters by the looks of it. Right, come on, surely you must be able to see us now. Surely. Oh, that's not you. That's taking a little bit of a pounding. Let's have a quick check. So most of their stuff is pretty fresh. I think in a ranged fight, we've definitely got them hands down. That That seems like quite an aggressive. That looks like they're flying in. Does that look like they're flying into a formation? Is it worthwhile changing our formation? A nice line abreast. Oh! Oh, they've left. How very dare you? How very, very dare you? Right, is there a way to tell? Like, oh, so you can tell how many far distances there are. So that's 87 clicks. Have they decided to wait for reinforcements? Did they get bored? Right, so Riders Bane Fleet. How far? So that's 61 clicks. From that to that, that's 38 clicks. So I reckon if we fly and wait there. We should in with a little bit of a shout here. The line abreast, so we should be in a nice neat line. We got supply ships coming in and mining ships that we can take out. Where are the old Reddit?
Imperial Star Destroyer 2.
Who's engaging?
You're not much of a pilot, are you?
We're afraid of you.
Huh? Confirmed. Good. Trash talk. A little minor. You're not much of a pilot, are you? Wow, I'm taking shield damage from launching fighters. I repaired all my ships. I know I did. Let's try and get this party started a bit.
Jump beacon.
Alright, so this is a nice distance. I mean, is it worthwhile us cutting into
Acclimator 1 transport?
Start attacking defense their station? Platform. I think we can do that. I mean, one thing we could potentially do is fly behind, get the fleet to fly behind the gate. Don't do this to me.
Autopilot engaged.
Ooh. Is this because I've got my guys set on attack? That's fine. Drifting a little bit there, buddy.
Autopilot disengage.
She can make enemies of the banking clan drones again. We'll focus up on that pellet though once we get a bit closer.
Striking!
Delta Class 1 transport.
Ah, first catch of the day. I just want to change the target in just for the briefest moment to attack my current enemy. That way we should.
Incoming missile.
You fire your missiles. You think I care about your missiles? I do actually. Missiles can do damage to me.
Danger.
Spin around.
Danger.
Mercy.
Mercy. We do not give out mercy. Right, so we need to keep an eye, ideally, on the gates. That's one. So we got so quick the old map.
You're not much of a pilot, are you?
Right, so for me we're in a good position at the minute for when that fleet drops through and any ships the New Republic tries to send in for trade supplies, we can pop them. Let's just flip herself over. Pelter's now running away.
Awaiting orders.
You just protect that little area.
Defense platform.
And we're going to change our turrets to attack all enemies. We want you on capitals. You on capitals. You on capitals. And the rest just attack whatever you want.
We were hit.
Ooh. Royal Guard Tides got destroyed. What does this mean?
Awaiting orders.
It's nice to see the repair drones are actually doing the job.
Awaiting orders.
Oh, so it's a little patrol group that's coming from behind us. That would have been the one that was up in Odd Mantel. I mean, there's no way that can survive under that kind of firepower. Just tip the wing, just so we've got all shots on board.
Requesting permission to dock. Docking permission
granted. Alright, we've blown this station up here. My vision is firmly locked on this gate here at the minute.
GR75.
You served your Republic well.
Defense platform.
And you should be dead now. Oh, you've still got a couple of the build modules. On the go. Pick up a little bit of loot while it's there. And she's gone. Boom, boom. Right. So I'm in a little bit of a precarious position as it stands at the minute. Because if anything does jump in, we're a bit nicky nacky nude. Now, we could try the same tactic as the New Republic, which would be to build a defense station. Near there, at the minute, I am relatively happy just to kind of like sit and wait until we've got a little bit more money and get that third ISD in. 83 million, that should be enough to get an ISD. Mainly because we did say we were going to get probably a fourth ISD too, weren't it? We did say we were going to get one. Call it the Ronin. Thanks to Ronin's all his wonderful help on the old Discord. It is really good to see when like a mod community is so strong as the one in X4. Alright, so we're gonna just quickly place our order for one brand new ISD2. I would like to buy a ship, please. I would like to buy an extra large ship and an Imperial Star Destroyer 2. 73 million. That is a good price. Thank you very much. And we still got 9 million in the bank. So we're going to need to order some fighters for it, ideally. You know, because we haven't put the game under enough stress as it stands at the minute. Oh, that is a beautiful vision. Look at that. That is a fleet and a half. Right, so how long have we got on the ISD2? Half an hour. Okay. We're getting our ships docked. They're in a nice position. So what we're going to do then is we'll order some more raiders. To bulk out that, because we can get them for free, essentially. I want to try and get 5 raiders per Star Destroyer, essentially. And we will get we'll get some more victories, I think. I mean, the victory's all right. I don't actually like the victory that much because they're pretty fragile. We might look at getting some Imperial light cruisers instead. We'll give them a go. So let's order up some ships from our shipyard. We're setting up a nice blockade.
Acknowledged.
I would buy an immobilizer, but they have a habit of breaking everything.
A9 minor.
Oh, it's flying away. Will it get 3? Of course it will. Oh no, it's stopping. That was a bit silly. Oh. She's gone. She's gone, guys, but good. Oh, no. No, we've rammed her, apparently. The skimmer must be out of bombs. So he used his hull. Ah, it's just going to get through, I bet. Just going to get through. It's a hell of a lot of missiles. Oh, no, it's mining lasers. You would have thought mining lasers would do like a hell of a lot of damage to ships. You don't really. Unfortunately. You know, because a beam that is designed to cut through asteroids, which are built of all sorts of different metals and stuff like that, you would have thought a ship's hull would be pretty weak. If the Imperials just built a defence station, we'd be getting paid for all this right now. Well, we wouldn't actually. They don't always pay you, do they?
Awaiting orders.
Who's awaiting orders? Is it dead yet? Yeah, tough old bird, isn't it? The old miners. Is she even... Oh, she's getting outside her engagement range now. Oh, no, she get away. She's down 43%. Oh no, she's trying to turn around.
Awaiting orders.
To light cruisers. We'll buy a couple of light cruisers. Order some raiders. Order some ships to fill the belly of the Ronin. I'm thinking some TIE Strikers. Oh, is that it? We've given up. What a letdown, guys. What a letdown. So I'm thinking TIE Strikers. I'm going to pause the game a minute because while our attentions are divided. So let's order up. Build ships. I don't want to buy ships for myself. Currently editor ship mandatory. Oh, we're a bit low on missile components. That will dictate how many so fighter wise, otherwise we're gonna be waiting for a while. Shall we just we'll go all in. We'll order 20 raiders. No we won't, because that'll put us out of sync for our five raiders. Thank you very much. And I would also like to order these things seem to be doing well. These are by far my favourite. So we'll order, I don't know. We're going to give it 30 fighters. We're going to order 15 Royal Guard, and we're going to order 15 Z95s. That would be hilarious. 15 Defenders. Why not? Because these are back. I think these are probably one of the stronger. Oh wow, they're going to take a while to complete those orders. We've got 9 million in the old bank account at the minute. We can top that up to 13 million. And then we can also buy a ship. Buy a large ship. Buy a Imperial Light Frigate. A frigate could actually be quite good for us. It would fill a role. They're only 8 million. So let me just check the guns on these. So yeah, these got the D10s, and I believe the D10 an effective range of 12 kilometers. I thought they were further than that. D6, 9.9. What's the other ones that are on it? The XX9s. No, I thought that. Have they changed that? I'm sure they used to have a longer range. Oh well, and then it's got a couple of little anti-fighter jobbies. So piloting these myself and having these as your main ship, first Imperial playthrough I did, it got destroyed a lot. Because what happened is because the turrets are so big, and I think I've said this a million times, but the engines are massive, the turrets are massive. So what happens is the once the AI takes these out, it's pretty much defenseless, unfortunately. But 8 million, well, call it 9 million, that is a very cheap light cruiser, and we can order a couple of these. It'll not take too long for us to get those built up. So we're going to get a little bit of a hope. Plum for punishment. A little bit of a choppy cut at the minute. While I just kind of
awaiting orders.
Wait for ships to be built, wait for things to turn up, and we'll keep on adding to
awaiting orders.
The fleet and build that up, and then once that fleet I'm happy at the level of the fleet, then we're gonna move in. With any luck, while we're sat and waiting, because at the minute, from the Pritchard to that gate, we're at 43 clicks. And I believe, usually, when a ship comes through the jump gate, it doesn't just come out there. They usually jump about 10 clicks in. So we're nearly going to be in effective range. We better actually turn ourselves around. So yeah, so I'll see you very soon when we've got a fleet ready, and we'll move into the next system across, which is Dorin, I believe. So, welcome back. It's been a little while. I've been basically trying to wait for things to build, and I've bought a couple of light cruisers. What we need to do, or what I'm going to try and do, is use the... because we've got a lot of different things going on. I'm using this as kind of like a template for how the fleets will be lent, and then a fighter interception. The only time this will get the fourth one is if we end up with the like a bombardment squad. So I'm just waiting for some ships to turn up. I don't know why they're taking so long, to be honest, because we've been here for quite a while. We're running low on components, so we can't build any more ships at the minute. But one of the things more importantly that I've noticed is the New Republic has made a push into the redoubt and taken out this trading station. Now, if they carry on their push down that way, Jeddah's there. Jeddah's not quite ready to be defended yet. It's a big push. It'll take a while. But I think we need to start pushing back. And we do have the firepower to do so. Now, this, I sent it on exploring, but for whatever reason, it decided to take itself off to re-equip. So, yeah, we're gonna basically pop his nose through with our little TIE Phantom. Or are we? Or should we borrow this TIE Striker? Yes, we will. You've not got any silly behaviours, have you? No. Right, TIE so Striker. I'm going to borrow your ship for a minute.
Autopilot disengaged.
I think the usual slight collision issues. Start guidance to that object, just so we can see where the gate is, because I want to see what's on the other side of here. We've taken out quite a few little trade ships and some fighter patrols and stuff like that, but there's been nothing particularly meaningful pop through. Oh, hello.
Jump completed. Boring.
Right, let's just get an ample distance away, and we'll take a look at that fleet on the way back. FNG. Alright. So... let's see what's waiting for us. Pew, pew, pew. Do quite like the TIE Striker. One of the main weaknesses of the TIE Striker, it tends to overheat quite quickly on the weapons, and it looks ugly as sin. Right, so let me just pause that a minute. Ooh, you've sent through a mini fleet, it would appear. What have you got waiting on this side? So you've got Hammerhead Corvettes. Rocking it old school with the hammerheads. Very cool. Do like a hammerhead. Then they've got the ISD, MC-80. Right, I'd like to see what's in this system. You haven't actually got that much. The problem is we would be jumping in to see them. And we are going to have to make a push at some point soon. Regardless of what's happening. We have got the numbers to disable this fleet. We've got a torpedo boat, two torpedo boats, MC-80, ISD-1, MC-75. I mean, we could take that quite easy because our fleet is massive. So we'll get docked up. We'll run this gauntlet. It should give us a better idea of some numbers. Oh, they might have some more ships that we weren't aware of. Oh, that's quite a big fleet. Why don't you just come through the gate? Why don't you just come through the gate and we can just settle this? Right, gentlemen. Oh, so they've got... What's their big... So that's the MC-40B. And they've got the... their medium ships. So where's... Oh, it's the patrol dreadnought. So a couple of patrol dreadnoughts. No, that's not right. You've got seven... Don't get that. We got seven medium, large ships. One, two, three. Maybe there's something I'm not seeing here. Either way.
Jump completed. Vortex. Venator Star Destroyer.
I'm getting into my... Venator. I mean, when we took on the Raditz in the what were we in then? We were in the one of them patrol groups might be coming through. If this is the patrol, if this is a patrol. Oh, my fleet's decided to point every which way but Sunday. Okay. Just let them all fly by. That's fine. Honestly don't know what to do. I mean, obviously the gut instinct is to fly through and just fight them. Get up to the bridge. I want to go to the bridge.
Have you actually flown a real ship before?
A lovely formation. They were all sat nicely in a nice line, and now they've just gone all sorts of crazy. We'll take that miner out in spite. I mean, what would be useful for this fleet is the immobilizer, but I don't know how. I don't know if the immobilizer would essentially aggro your own. Yeah, I don't know if the immobilizer would aggro all his own stuff.
Awaiting orders.
So they're flying through. Oh, that is a stupid place for a satellite. In fact, when you've done your exploring job, can you place a satellite there? We can see better what's going on. So they're using that supply base. Might be able to get them on the return journey. And then grown attached to that TIE Phantom. So once you've done that, explore Bastion again. See if we can get some of these lower bits here. Never know. Might be a free Katana Fleet Dreadnought. Right, so I'll let everything get docked up, and then we will mobilise the fleet and we'll go through that gate. I think that's what we're going to do. I've not bought another light cruiser yet because they were costing us 8 million, and then the Empire decided that now they were going to cost us 10 million. Don't want to pay the prices for it. But yeah, so we'll wait for things to get docked up. Just so we're in some sort of reasonable order. Does look like these guys are going to be coming back through. Oh, here they are. Now, sometimes you find that they do, on the return journey, they do... guys, your speed into which you... launched. It's not acceptable. You need to be quicker. I thought they were going to slow down and try and attack them. Got another miner coming through. Okay. Right, so, yeah, no more dealing. We'll do a big battle and then we'll call it an episode, depending on how it goes. I will be dropping a quick save, because if we lose everything, I will be doing a reload. This is our checkpoint, so to speak. Striking. Welcome back. Right, so I'm not going to do an invasion. I feel bad because I feel like I've led everybody on. But I think what we're going to do is we're going to play it a bit more sensible. Instead, we're going to actually build a defense station in Vortex to try and get the New Republic to... attack us and push. I think that's going to be the best thing to do, because we were in a reasonably good position. Let's just remove that order. So let's do that. We'll get a little defense station built as some incentive, as some bait for them. Right, so we want a 4x4x4, create new plot. I want it about here. Continue. Load plan. Let's get a... Did we not save the little defense station? I thought I did. Add a class. There it is. Yeah. Where's the gate? I want you to face this way. need to go forward a bit. Alright, confirm module changes. Sign a higher builder. We'll get Atlas on the job. Hope Atlas doesn't get destroyed. Right, accept estimate. Confirm. Do we not have 9? Oh yeah, we've just done it. Not enough resources, that's fine. Right, cool. So we're going to start building that station here. Where's the New Republic at? Get off of building a station like that, eh? I don't want to, select it while you're in that menu. Nobody owns it. So when we own it, does that mean they're still trying to build it? That's still there. I mean, we could bring the scrapper down or buy another scrapper. Things doing alright down there. It's been fairly quiet at the minute, touch wood. So I'm going to get that station built. We should have enough to defend it if they decide to come in. And what we're going to do is we're going to get the Redis Bay and I'm going to fly a little bit closer. See if we can't get the rest of the fleet to get back into formation, because they seem to have fallen into a bit of chaos. And that's fine. We can deal with chaos. Shift and fall. What's this distance? 34. Not 0.61. Are you guys going in for? Are you going in to try and attack something? Are you? Or are you just trying to? All those TIE fighters come out of the belly of that beast. Boom, boom, boom. What guy? Oh, and look at all that down there. You get the raiders flying around. Right, guys, get yourself into formation. Get this station built. Once this station's built, we will see if that baits him in. Hoping it does.
Awaiting orders.
That would be the dream.
Awaiting orders.
We're kind of in a decent, as long as they don't start turning around, because obviously in a Star Destroyer you don't want the back end exposed, because that's usually, Star Destroyers are pretty good, they're mainly forward firing with the firing arcs.
Enemy spotted. Arc 170.
Is he supposed to be impressed by that? Well, we're eating that patrol three fleet up pretty well. See how this little A-wing gets on. Not well. Just look at all that. Oh my god, look at all those ships. I mean, surely on fighters alone we'd be able to win that battle. I don't want to risk it though. We've come too far. It's. Squeeze me. I don't really like what you just did there. I believe that is a capital punishment. Right, so next episode then, we're just gonna do a bit of defending and get this up, and we're gonna see if we can lure that fleet in. And in the meantime, what we'll be doing is we'll be building up our mega fleet, and then we'll be able to crush everything that comes through it. Because I'm done with the age-old kind of like you move forward, you take some stuff out, you lose all your ships, you come back, you move forward, you come out, yada yada yada. Because once we get rolling properly, I don't want to stop. That's the plan. So, as ever, thank you for watching. I have been Captain Jack Gumption. This has been the Imperial Warlord series. And I will see you next time.